anything, because it's like you're gonna retain it. You're gonna retain it 10 to 14. You're gonna retain, like, you know, what we're teaching you. You're gonna retain, you know, lessons easier than it would be if you were younger than it. And then also, it's just like the whole, like, the star concept. It's like, I love it. You know what I'm saying? Because it's setting you up for basketball, but it's really setting you up for life. Like, you know, you can't play basketball without, you know, respecting one another, respecting your culture, respecting, like, the game for itself, and then, like, being, like, showing, like, a good attitude all the time. It's you know, attitude matters everything. You can get through, any or anything with the right attitude. So, that's, like, big points here.
Okay, you were one of those players that took 3 years to get to the NBA, and not many players do that right now. What is the importance of, on your opinion, is taking time in developing your game in the college ranks before hitting the pros?
A lot of it's mental development. Not so much your game. I mean, it is your game too, but, like, you know, if my mental was right, I probably would have left my first year. But, you know, my mentality wasn't right for the NBA yet. And in the second year, like, I thought it was, you know, better. And I ended up breaking my ankle, so I was like, nah, I'm not supposed to go. And the third year was just like, all right, you got out of here. Coach kept pushing me out the door. That happened to be, you know, one of my best years. And, like, hoops wise, then, you know, learned a lot from Coach Cal in those 3 years, and I think prepared me for the league.
Okay, would you recommend players to take time in college before getting to the NBA?
I think it, you know, it depends on the player. I don't necessarily believe, you know, that you have to spend 4 years in college and develop, blah, blah, blah. If you're good enough and mentally right enough to go out for a month, you know, go do it. Go pursue your dream and, you know, change some lives. But if, you know, it takes 1 or 2 or 3 years, 4 years, I don't think that hinders a player if he stays longer. For some reason, that perception had got out in the world that, you know, if you take more time doing something, that you're not going to be as good at it. I don't know. But I think it's just a pitch on the player.
One question about your fashion name, your clothing name. Can you give us a little background about it?
Yeah, man, I've been scheming on it since I was, like, an eighth grader. Just like, always thought. Getting an interview from people, it's just, you know, what are the things that you like doing? I want a clothing line, and I want to be able to sell it at a store. So it's, like, always been one of my big things, like, outside of basketball, you know, creating.
So you have any plans to bring it over here to the Philippines?
I'll bring it anywhere. they want it, I'll bring it here, that's for sure. I definitely, you know, have aspirations of it being, like, a global brand. And I think there needs to be another sporting brand that's out here besides Nike and Adidas and Puma and all these other things. They need a wheel change sports.
Yeah. It's a little weak for that.
So it's here. And I'm in the beginning stages, and I've got, you know, my first product run done. I'm working on season 2 and, like, season 3. You know, it's already being drawn up, so it's always fun. But I definitely will bring it out here.
All right. Okay.
Jumping on from this question, a lot of NBA players, when they retire, they lose their money in 3 years span, and it's a documented case. So you're already starting to invest in businesses, and as early as your second year in the league. So how is it important for young players like you that to reinvest their money to better things?
Yeah, I mean, you know, at the end of the day, it's a job. You know, hoops is fun. You know, you grow up playing, it's fun, really fun. but at the end of the day, you gotta live, you gotta survive, and this is my job. You know, so, like, it's not all you play this game, you get this money, it lasts forever. You play this game, you get this money, you put it in other things, you get more money, and then you become, you know, an ambassador. You do things with the people that you meet, and, you know, that's the length of money that you get, but it's really, you know, the relationship that you can, you know, use your money for. That's, like, you know, we learned that at a young age, by staying 3 years in college, and, you know, Coach Cal taught us that. You know, I learned a lot from financially from him on that standpoint.
I'm curious about your tattoo on your forehead. What's the three piece on your forehead?
Triple P, philosophical peace and power. You know, I think, you know, the biggest thing for anything is like mental. If your mental health is right and you're mentally ready to endure anything, you can do anything. So that's where it comes from. So if you're mentally right, you'll be peaceful at the end.
Really, the NBA lottery will be held tomorrow. Of course, the Sacramento Kings will be participating in the draft lottery again. If they could be fortunate enough to get at least a top three pick tomorrow, who do you want them to get and why?
Man, I don't even know. I got my young dudes that played in my organization, AAU team, Mokan, Trae Young. I would love to see Trae Young or Michael Porter, just because they played, you know, through my AAU team.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see them, you know, do as well as I'm doing. So why not come to the same team?
Okay, since it's a Final Four round, who do you want to see in the NBA Finals?
I would like to see the Celtics and Rockets, just for a change in culture. Just a change in culture would be really, really cool. But it's probably going to be the Warriors and Cavs, but the Warriors are probably going
to
see.
Not the thing you're kind of saying that they lost that Houston Rockets lost very few Golden State.
I was watching it earlier. You know, it's always weird. You know, we seen LeBron get beat by 20 yesterday. He's probably gonna come back and win by 20 tomorrow. That's how it goes. But it's really a toss up. It's hard to even. This is like the fifth time I had to answer this question. It's hard.
We have a high school kid here. He's 16 years old. He's 7 feet tall like you. His name is Kai Soto. He's playing for the national team. What kind of advice would you give him in order to be a better basketball player?
You know, I don't know, you know, too much about him, so like, you know, I don't know.
I mean, he's growing. I mean,
he's also part of doing NBA.
Yeah.
Right. So, I mean, work, man, work, and like, master your craft. You know, your craft. Don't let nobody tell you what your craft is. I think that's the most important thing that I could say. You know, how can somebody tell you what you want to do? I think that's the most, like, the important, the sole thing that I can push to somebody is just, you know, whatever your craft is, write it down, and then write how to reach your craft, write how to, you know, how to attain what you want to do with your game, and just keep on perfecting it with your time.
With more and more NBA big men shooting from the trees in today's era, is there a concerted effort on your part to develop your three-point shooting, or would you just focus on developing your post moves instead?
I'm just, you know, really focused on developing like a complete game, which that's in it. You know, right now I'm working more mid-range. You know, I would like to become one of the best mid-range shooters in the game. So I work a lot of mid-range and continue to you know, master the post, but I think I'm too fast, too athletic, can do too many good things to try to live myself as just being a post player.
Okay, it was Mother's Day here, and I know how much you love your mother and all, and how do you think, how important is it for your parents to be there for your child in developing their skills as a basketball player?
Any type of support, through mother, father, uncle, nephew, cousin, like any type of that love and support is gonna get you to where you wanna go. You know, you're blessed if it comes from your mom or your dad, but you're really blessed if it comes from anybody. So any type of support is gonna be good eventually for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right. This is the selfie capital of the world, so it's mandatory that we all have a selfie.